President Obama took the stage in St. Louis, Missouri, with a speech reminiscent of the campaign trail. He focused on health reform, an insurance marketplace, and cost control.
We've incorporated almost every serious idea from across the political spectrum about how to contain rising health care costs. There's not an idea out there that we have not worked on.
The historic health care bill is facing stiff resistance from Republicans, doubtful Democrats, and a weary American public. And some business groups are willing to spend big money to oppose it.
Congress's latest health care bill makes a tough economy worse.
So the president is taking his argument to the people.
Nowhere is reform more needed than when it comes to our health care system.
The Obama administration is gearing up for a big congressional House vote on health care, possibly within weeks. The White House website now features health reform by the numbers, spotlighting different statistics on the debate. Today's number, 8. The White House says that's the number of people every minute who are denied coverage, charged a higher rate, or otherwise discriminated against because of a pre-existing condition.
Premiums are quite high and they're growing really fast. Health insurance premiums don't seem to have noticed that there's a recession.
John Hollihan analyzes the cost point structure of health care reform. He says taxpayers should expect to pay a lot more in health care costs in upcoming years if legislation falls through.
There's a difference of about in the neighborhood of $300 billion that we would be saving relative to what would be the case if there was no reforms.
The president will attempt to drive home his message in the final days leading up to a vote.
We are not backing down. We are not quitting St. Charles, and we are going to get this done.
With skepticism growing in both parties and from the American public, President Obama wants legislation to move swiftly. Democrats will most likely try to pass a health care reform bill with little or no GOP support. Colin Campbell, Washington.